My brother, hello. I'm going to share with you today, man, a really quite extreme perspective, but one that might really help you quit and transform out of pornography. Okay? Dude, I'm on your team here. Let's do this. I'm not going to be holding back. I'm just going to be giving you everything that I've got. Okay? I've got some notes in front of me. Let's do this, man. Okay, so the first thing you need to know, man, is this. NoFap is a game. Okay? And you probably already noticed, man, that the game is kind of fucking bullshit. Because it's endless and it's repetitive. It's just the same bullshit relapse cycle over and over and over again. And like, if you really zoom out, man, and you really think, like, dude, like, really though, how am I going to stop this? Like, how is it actually going to come to an end? I share this with you, man, because I got to this point. I was like, Jesus, man, like, seriously though, how am I going to stop this? Like, seriously, you know? And it got me to think in really deep ways. So this is what I realized about this, okay? So NoFap, as I said, it's a game. And the only way you can actually win the game is you stop playing the game. You get tired of the suffering and you go play some other game instead. So in other words, man, the way that you win the game is you seamlessly integrate it into the background of your life. And you might be like, dude, how the fuck do I do that? Well, that's what I mean when I say you got to stop playing it. Because you can't win the game. I don't know if you've seen, man, like you can't win it. It's endless. And part of you, man, will genuinely be like, well, dude, well, I can't have that. I can't just, you know, this is my fucking life here. Like, Jesus, man, come on. Like, I'm living my life. Surely this isn't it. Surely this isn't how, you know, how good it gets. Is that it? You know, you'll just be like, what is life? It'll get you to think existentially, man. And so, you know, when you've got to that level, man, what you might do is you might be like, okay, well, all right, okay, I'm open to, you know, not playing this game, whatever you mean by that. What does that mean exactly? Well, what I mean why that, dude, is this. When you stop playing the game of NoFap, what happens, dude? It just seamlessly blends into your life. And you might have a voice within you that's like, well, fucking hell, man. How the fuck do I do that? That sounds really, like, advanced, but, like, you're making it sound like it's really simple. Well, that's the thing, man. So the reason it sounds like that is because we're not playing the game anymore. You see, we're not doing it. There's no effort required. Because we're actually surrendering the game. And you might be like, all right, man, I can give that a shot. What do I need to do to, you know, surrender this game? And this is the fun part, man. So I created a list, brother, of all the stuff that you've got to give up. Yeah, and I want to read it out to you. So I'm going to be, you know, referring to this list, but let's do it, man. So to stop playing the game of NoFap, you need to commit to the following. No counting days. No streaks. No watching NoFap videos, no Reddit, no GIFs, no images, no videos, no websites, no Instagram babes, no Snapchat babes, no TikTok girls, no cam girls, no ASMR, no bookmarks, no dopamine scrolling, no doom scrolling, no softcore, no incognito mode, no OnlyFans, no nudes, no hard drives, no sexy cartoons, no erotic literature, no edging, no peeking, no fantasizing, no relapsing. You're done. I tell you this because I've done this. You want to do this too, man, but you're afraid of making the change. Because some of the stuff on this list, man, it feels nice. It's nice to escape. It's nice to use. It feels fucking great. Except that it doesn't, brother. Except that it feels like shit. Except that it's actually like really sour. It sours the soul, man. It makes you feel like fucking shit. You'll try and apply restraint and you'll try and apply self-discipline. But when you actually want to do this stuff, man, you'll just fucking do it anyway. You don't give a shit. You'll relapse. You'll go back. But then, man, you hit points of like, Jesus, man, I can't continue with this shit, man. Come on. For me, man, it just hurt too much. And I don't mean like I'm missing out on this and that hurts. It's like, I'm just not even fucking in my body, bro. I'm just fucking in my head. I didn't enjoy that, man. I couldn't live my life if I was, you know, just here. I had to make some changes, man. And not only just, you know, not do this, not do that. That doesn't fucking work, bro. That's the game. Instead, man, and this is subtle, but you'll get this. Instead, what's needed is something called a paradigm shift. So it's not just, oh, let me go for a 30-day streak, brother. It's, dude, let me fucking change the structure of my beliefs. You want to do this too. You want to make the change. But you're struggling to make the change because that shit's tempting as fuck. Of course, man. But dude, fuck that. You can make the change. And you know how you're going to make the change, dude? You're going to stop playing the game of NoFap. That's what you're going to do, man. The reason you got to stop playing the game, man, is because basically you can only get the same shit results by playing the game. When you play this game of NoFap, man, you just get the same shitty results over and over and over again. In fact, man, this is the biggest breakthrough. You ready? NoFap actually keeps you stuck. Because NoFap implies that you could relapse at some point. NoFap, the idea of NoFap and playing the game of NoFap, makes it really easy for you to go back to relapsing, because relapsing is integral to the game of NoFap. It's part of the game, yeah? But can you see that you would break free if you completely changed your paradigm and you played a different game over here? Another issue with the NoFap game is it keeps the idea of pornography alive. It keeps it alive in your mind and it keeps it alive in your world. So this means, dude, that you're involving and including the pornography idea, the relapsing idea. You're thinking, oh, what day am I on? Let me not go back. Now, you might be like, dude, yeah, that's fucking how you do it. But what I would suggest to you, man, is that if you really do care about like fucking moving on properly, you would have to surrender those ideas, those thoughts, and those associations. Because if you really think about it, man, when you've been free, when you've been away from it or on a really, really, you know, good streak, you're not thinking about it. But when you're stuck in it and you keep going through the same bullshit relapsing patterns, it's because it's in your mind, even just as an idea. You're thinking about it. You're thinking about not doing it, or you're thinking about, oh, I could do it, or you're thinking about it, you know, can I get away with it? It's in the mind altogether. And what I've realized being away from it for a while now, man, is this. For you to be a properly free person, a properly free man or woman, dude, you're not thinking about it. You're just not thinking about it. And you've got to, man, make the connection between, oh shit, I'm having these thoughts because I'm still in this NoFap paradigm. I'm playing the NoFap game. Also, man, notice, you might not realize you're playing the NoFap game. When you do go on to, you know, remove yourself from it and transform and shift your paradigm, you gain like paradigm awareness. You kind of take a step back and you're like, shit, I was in that paradigm, but I didn't see that I was in that paradigm. The people who will not get this, man, will remain stuck and be like, oh, I mean, I heard your video, man, but like, I'm still fucking stuck. It's because they didn't realize that they're in that fucking paradigm. You know what I'm doing with this video, man? I'm giving you paradigm awareness. I'm lending a hand and I'm saying, hey, man, do you want to come and take a look at this view? Because you might be able to see some things from here. And I don't mean that in some lofty bullshit egotistical way. No, man. I'm saying you can become more aware of the way that your mind has constructed reality. And basically, man, because it's been constructed in a way where this NoFap thing is still there and it's, you know, getting you the same bullshit results, I'm saying, dude, take a look at this. See it from this perspective, from this paradigm aware perspective, where you can be like, dude, you know, I see that for about a decade or two, I've been playing this game. I've been stuck in pornography. I haven't realized I've been stuck in pornography. But now that you say that I can really take a step back and realize that I can all play a different game entirely, this opens up a new possibility. The next issue with NoFap game is basically, man, it disempowers you because you have got to try to not do something. And really, man, you won't appreciate the effort that you've got to put in to not do this thing. Now, honestly, man, self-restraint and self-discipline are awesome. I back that completely. But you'll notice that for you to kind of even exist in this NoFap paradigm, you've got to kind of put an effort in to not do something. You're always denying yourself. You're always saying no to something. And to be honest with you, man, that's a bit of effort. It's quite taxing. It's like, oh man, I'm just in this constant reality where like, oh, I shouldn't be doing this thing. The truth is, man, if you want to empower yourself, you know what you do? You stop playing the game. You stop playing the game of NoFap and that constant effort of, oh, shit, I better not relapse. Oh, shit, Friday, Saturday's coming up. Better not relapse on that night. Oh, shit, free afternoon, free evening. I better not relapse then. I better try, you know, better make sure I have plans then. do you see, man, how like this is so much effort? Even this thinking falls away when you've shifted your paradigm, because you don't need to put any effort into not doing it, because you're not playing that game. The next point is, dude, it's always going to be endless. And it's always going to be the same repetitive bullshit. If you aren't, you could say, spiritually impatient, you just fucking are done because you're spiritually exhausted with this shit, then you'll realize, you know, man, it is endless. I can see, like, just looking back logically, like, you know, it didn't stop. It's still going and it's just going to continue into the future. If you are a wise motherfucker, you just slow down. You're like, dude, I better get a grip on this because it's not going to stop. You know, if you just really sit down and you think about it, it's not going to stop. It's the same thing. When you're playing the game, you necessitate the result of a relapse. A relapse is included within the game. So if you play the game, you're gonna have a relapse. And again, once you've sat back and really, like, you know, thought about stuff, man, you're like, well, I don't want that anymore. I don't. So, brother, the reason we say all of this, honestly, man, is because we're not trying to cope. We're trying to move on. We're trying to transform. And do you see the difference there, dude? If you're kind of stuck, if you're kind of depressed, if you kind of feel like you need PMO and you don't really want to do this deep, deep work about transforming a paradigm, you might be in that coping phase. But let's say you've done that for quite a while, a decade, a couple of decades, and you're like, you know what, man? I think I'm ready. I think I've got the courage to try this other approach. It might be the fucking death of me and the death of my ego, but I'm willing to be open and change my paradigm. So honestly, man, a large amount of this work is feeling into yourself and actually just feeling who you are. I say that, man, because, like, a lot of the time we can just block out what is true, because if we were to feel it, we would now have a contradiction in our experience, because we know of this thing, we've got a bit of consciousness on it, but we also, like, been pushing it down with this PMO thing. We're repressing it. And so when, like, in other words, when you see it and you feel it, you make it come alive. You make that more of your experience. But it's really tricky, man, because you're kind of afraid of it. You know that, like, if you were to feel that all the way, that would rise to the surface and you'd be who you truly are. And that'll scare the shit out of you, man. Because you know what? Because that implies massive change. And what is change but a form of death? You know, just all the stuff that's got to change. All the little things, all the not hiding, all the little not running away from this, you know, really you're honoring your higher self, and you're becoming a man. You're becoming the man, you know, the guy that you are. And whether you're a woman, it could be the same thing. You're just allowing that authentic person to come through. And then from that place, that's where you live from. The other thing I'd say is this, there is a creation component to this. What I mean by that, dude, is basically you want to create a new game to play. Because when you don't have a game to play, your mind will just sort of try and take control, and it will try and make you do some unconscious things because there's no real fun game to live into. So what you want to do, brother, is you want to create a life purpose that aligns with this person that you truly are. In other words, build a vision and develop a purpose that is something that you can do and sort of almost chase after and pursue like a motherfucker as a means of creating a gulf between who you once were and who you are now. Basically, man, it's you reimagining yourself. And you reimagine yourself and your life with, you know, new vision, new perspective, new standards, new boundaries. You become someone different to your NoFap self. You look back and you're like, oh yeah, I remember when I used to play around with that. I was playing that game. You see, even the way you talk about it will be different, man. I remember not winning that game, like every few days or every week, you know, because that's ultimately what drives us, man. It's the relapsing. It's the suffering. You cannot, with good conscience, continue playing the game when you know yourself that you can't win it, that it's going to keep happening. And honestly, brother, you might need another 3 to 5 to 10 years of playing the game and being asleep and being addicted. Honestly, bro, that's okay. I did that. At some point, you'll have enough consciousness to make a change and to finally, finally break free. I had to do this for myself. And, you know, you can watch all my other NoFap videos that I've ever done, and they will help you. They'll, you know, point out some good stuff. But when it comes down to it, if you are still within the paradigm of NoFap, just remember, you're going to get those same results that you always have. Final thing I'm going to share with you today, man, is this. If you feel like I can help you with where you're at and help you create this paradigm shift so that you never need to deal with this bollocks again, you can see the link in the description. You can book a call with me. If you want to speak with me to help create this and finally fucking move on, my brother, here is your invitation. If not, that's okay too. Keep being where you're at. Keep burning through your karma. Remember, you might be asleep for another fucking 10, 15 years before you feel like you can really wake up and change your paradigm. Just keep that in mind, dude. Okay. All right, man. We're going to call things there. Dude, lots of love. Take care, my friend. And as always, dude, peace.